Hello, myself Dr. Beena Trivedi. I am obstetrician and gynecologist from Rajkot, that is in Gujarat. My husband is Dr. Nimish Trivedi, he is a neurosurgeon here. I have two kids. My son is studying in AFMC Pune in medical college. And my daughter is studying in USA and she is doing bachelor in neuroscience. So that is about my family. Then what about me? Of course, I am obstetrician and gynecologist, but still I like music, dancing. I have done Kathak. When I finished my 12th, I did my Kathak. Even I like to do aerobic exercise and yoga and fitness as a whole. I would like to do swimming also. That also I learned once I crossed 45 years age. Yeah. And today, during this lockdown, I started learning new things. That's a new language. So I'm doing nowadays online French learning from the Duolingo. So that also I'm enjoying. So I would like you all to invite to my kitchen. So let's go. Welcome to my kitchen. Hello. Many items came in my mind what to make. Then I thought, being a Gujarati and staying in Gujarat, let's make some authentic Gujarati dish. So you know, we all Gujarati love vegetable handvo too much. So I would like to make vegetable handvo for all of you today. So let's see ingredients first. So for that, vegetable handvo is a complete mixture of food. It's a complete meal. So in that we are using rice, even three type of dals, moong dal, tuvir dal, urad dal, chana dal. So the proportion, the rice proportion, like if it's 100%, then 25-30% is chana dal and another 25-30% includes moong dal and other three dals, urad dal and even you can have masoor dal also in it if you would like to incorporate. And then this is rice and dal mixture. And other items are vegetables. You can take any vegetables of your choice. Today I have taken carrot, bottle gourd, that is called dudi, corn, even groundnuts, and peas, green peas. You can add many more things if you want, if you like the other vegetables like spinach and many more. Today I have taken 2 tablespoons of fenugreek. It's a like dried methi fenugreek I have soaked overnight. And then when we'll put 2 tablespoons inside it, it enhances taste. So then what we have to do? Complete all the ingredients, soak in a water for at least 4 hours, like rice and dal mixture. Soak in a water for 4 hours. Then remove the water, make it a fine paste. Paste is little coarse, not very fine. And then again, when while making the paste, put 2 tablespoons of curd because we want to make it ferment. So we put 2 tablespoons of curd in it and then we are going to mix in a coarse paste. So for all of you, I have made the paste ready for you. So now we are going to make the things from it. So first of all, just put the paste in a bowl. Then add all the vegetables inside it. So first of all goes this carrot, then goes the bottle gourd, then goes groundnuts. This I have roasted little bit. This is boiled corns, then boiled green peas, then 2 tablespoons of fenugreek. It will help in fermentation. Then coriander leaves. Then this is chili and ginger paste. So that you can put according to your taste, how much spice you want. And then all the dry masalas. So this put salt as per your taste. Then red chilies. Then turmeric for its nice color and even to give antiseptic properties. And then dhania powder. Then make a good mix all out of it. So can you see it's a complete mixture of rice, dal and vegetables. So we can say it is a complete meal. And you can't believe it. It is so delicious. It is so glamorous. It is good mix. Then Then at the end, we are going to put 2 tablespoons of oil. And then magic ingredient, that is fruit salt. I have taken ginkgo powder, this one, right? So take 2 tablespoons of ginkgo powder in it to make it ferment. Yeah. Then give a good mix. So this our batter is ready. Now we are going to make delicious salty cake out of it. So can you see? This is ready with dal and rice mixture. Now go to the gas, put on the gas. Today I am going to give you 2 varieties, one in the gas and one in the microwave. So in the gas, we are going to put 2 tablespoons of oil in it. I am again taking oil in another pan to put it in microwave. And we would like to saute it with cumin. Then take some leaves, curry patta. Put similar things in another oil pot also. Allow it to pop. Right. Once it gets pops, we'll put the sesame seeds. I have taken white sesame seeds. So we'll put white sesame seeds. Can you see nice pop? Then put a batter inside it. So I'm going to pour it. I am thinking to put it in the microwave, in the oven. Not microwave, we'll put OTG, we'll put in OTG. Yeah. Nice cake will become ready. Put the lid over it. Make the flame very very slow. This is very important. You have to make the flame very very slow while making it. If you are making flame high, then it will get burned and the middle part will not get properly cooked. Now this is for the oven. So I'll take the oven pot. So we'll put little oil mixture in that. And put the remaining part to get baked. Yeah. And over it again we'll put little one. So this will go in preheated oven at 180 degree for half an hour. So let's wait. Now we'll have to wait for 20 minutes. After 20 minutes we are going to flip the pot so that it will get cooked from both the sides. So let's wait for 20 minutes. 25 minutes are over, so let's check. Now we'll just see from the sides. I think it is done from one side, so it's time to flip it. So it's little tricky method. Put a dish over it and then just, yeah, then put it again over it and now we are going to transfer. See how nice it is from one side. So again transfer the entire handle. Yeah. It is really mouth watering, right? But still, wait for 5-10 minutes to get it over cooked from other side also. So another we have put in the oven. So it has heat from both the sides. So no need to flip the things which is put in the oven. So we'll still wait for more 15 minutes to get it cooked in the oven. I think now 15 minutes are over. I think it is done, but still I would like to cross check it. So we'll put a fork, pierce it inside and just take it out. See, nothing is sticked over the stick. So we can say that it is done. So we'll put off the gas now. So it's ready. Let's see. It is nicely. Wow. Yeah. So this is also ready. I just took it out from the oven. So this is two different way we can make, either in the oven or on the gas. So both are possible. So let's cut. It's our salty cake, complete full meal. It's so glamorous to look at it, and it's delicious in taste. See how it looks? So we can take it with the chutney or any dip you like tomato ketchup or green chutneys, and you can take with juice or maybe tea or coffee. You can take it in the dinner. You can have takeaway whenever you are going out for work, or maybe you are going outside, then you can take it in the lunch box. So you can give it to kids. You can impress your guest. So I'm sure you all will incorporate this item in your day-to-day kitchen. So you will incorporate in your menu and relish it. Thank you all.